We welcome basketball fans back here to Kirk Hall. We get set for the men's game. Captain Cam Pollock here with us. Cam, we said it in the girls' game. You don't really need any pep talks for a game against your rivals.
No, you don't. You know, just as soon as you hear SM, you're up and ready for that game no matter what.
Well, tonight you guys are back at full strength. You've been playing a little undermanned here at times. And so tell us a little bit about the practices leading up to tonight's big game here. How's everything looking?
You know, I think it's been looking good. You know, we've been challenging each other in practice. We've been competitive. You know, everybody wants to work for that, you know, that starting spot, you know. So everybody's staying competitive. We're getting shots in. We're playing defense. You know, I think we got some stuff to show tonight for sure.
Yeah, some stuff to show, and this is a big YSCC game here. Really want to end the semester, basically the first half of the season, but it's actually a little more than the first half of the season, isn't it, when you look at the numbers of games played. So this is a big league tilt tonight.
Yeah, for sure. You know, this game, we always have it at the end of the semesters, and just like the second semester too, but you know, this one's a big one. You know, we haven't started off too hot, so this is going to be a good one to, if we can get this win, to go back into the break, you know, off a win, it's going to be big. But well, we're coming with everything.
Well, certainly, as you saw in the women's game, a packed house here tonight. How's it feel playing in cozy Kirk Hall with a packed house?
You know, it feels good. We haven't had this packed house all year, so you know, it's just, your adrenaline is just, it's crazy right now. So, but as long as we keep our composure, one play at a time, you know, that crowd, if it starts to fade away, you don't really listen to them, you don't really hear them once the game starts.
Okay, Cam, we're going to let you go here so you can finish your warm-ups. Thanks for coming on with us.
I appreciate it.
Always a gentleman, Cam Pollock. Turn it over to Jim Toomey here. He'll have the pregame coming up right now.
All right, let's look at the Southern Maine Seawolves. Coached by Matt Richards, his 21st year. Had 368 wins coming in. He's a graduate of Colby Sawyer, and of course, the Seawolves national champs in 2022. Assistant coaches A.J. Burton, Tyler Clark, Ian Regan, Jackson Carr, and John Lemio. They got like an NBA staff. Seawolf 7-4 overall, 2-2 in the conference, 3-2 at home, 3-2 on the road, 1-0 at neutral sites. SM scores 80.9 points a game while giving up 74.2. They shoot 45.9 from the floor, 28.8 from long distance, and 71.5 at the foul line. They're coming off a loss against Vermont State Randolph, the old Vermont Tech team, 74-60. Some of their leaders, Luke Briggs scores 13.5 a game, Thomas Martinotti 13.1, Randy Vasquez 10.8, Adam Savage 10.5. Vasquez, the leading rebounder at 8.9, Savage at 8.8. In the assist department, Martinotti is 3.5, and Savage 2.9. The Central Maine Mustangs, led by coach Dave Gagne, assisted by Steve Carey and Jared Rubin. CM 5-7 overall, 1-4 in the conference. They lost a number of close games. They're 3-3 at home, 2-4 on the road. They score 88.4 points a game while giving up 81.4. They shoot 47% from the floor, 32.7 from behind the arc, and 71.9 at the foul line. They're coming off a game last Friday that we did here on Munsey Media Sports. A very hard battle against Washington County Community College and coach Troy Alley. And it was only at the very last 7 or 8 minutes that CM pulled away for a 94-70 win. Individual players and the stat sheet for CM: Boston Caldwell, 17.9 points a game. Jackson Birmingham, 14.2. Wyatt Hathaway, 12.5. Cam Pollock, 11.6. Birmingham also leads in rebounds at 7.2. Colin Wilson has 5.1 rebounds. Cam Pollock has 4.7 rebounds, and Harry Bates, 4.8. In the assist department, guess who? Jackson Birmingham, 5.4. And Cam Pollock, 3.8. These teams met three times last year. At South Portland, it was 64-51 for the Seawolves. On this court, Central Maine won 73-54. And then in the playoffs, right here on this court, a really hard battle that was. Talk about a battle. The Seawolves prevailed in the tournament 62-59. And now our public address announcer, Steve English.
Would like to announce and acknowledge a milestone win tonight. Tonight's win over the Seawolves was Coach Morong's 300th win as a college head coach. Let's give it up for Coach Andrew Morong.
And I want to acknowledge Jim Toomey, who did the legwork on finding that out. As soon as Jim got into the gym tonight, he said, I think this will be Andrew's 300th win. Great job, Jim. That's great. Great work, Jim.
For tonight's All right, thank men's you, Rob. Basketball game between the Southern Maine Community College Seawolves and your Central Maine Mustangs. Before we introduce the teams, we would like to recognize our sponsors, Sam's Italian Shops, Investment Executives, Central Maine Conditioning Clinic, Paychex, Northeast Event Design, Edge Nutrition, Munzing Media, and the Quality Inn and Suites. We encourage you to patronize their establishments. First, the starting lineup for the visiting Seawolves. Number 4, Cayman Warburton. Number 12, Luke Briggs. Number 13, Thomas Martinotti. Number 14, Randy Vasquez. Number 15, Adam Savage. Head coach Matt Richards. Seawolves assisted by A.J. Burton, Tyler Clark, Ian Regan, and John Lemieux.
Hey, fellas, we ain't gonna ever back down from nobody. Who it is? This is a brotherhood, and if we stand strong together, we can't be denied. If one of us go down, we have another, and another, and another that's ready to fight.
Yeah. And hit records on my demo. Did y'all boys not get the memo? I do not stay at the Intercontinental. And anything I got is not a rental. I own that mom. Figured out this shit is simple. My stock been going up like a crescendo. A bunch of handshakes from the flakes. But I do not wanna be friends though. I tell y'all, mom.
Coach Gagne on mic tonight. Let's get his final thoughts. Didn't have the mic turned on my end of it, Jim. Oh, well.
We'll get him. Mustangs in their home uniforms going left to right. Seawolves And the Road Blues going the other direction, which works out well.
Yeah, behind it, they're going in the same direction, Jim.
Hope you enjoyed this one on Munzing Media. Goes out of bounds right in the hands of Coach Matt Richards.
Well, Matt was sitting, which is not his usual operation.
Stopwatch on it and see how long.
Matt, very out. Love Matt. What a great coach he is.
Birmingham got it into Simeon. Pollock. As we said a couple of times, Cam Pollock has like grown like 2 years in 1 year in a variety of ways. Inside, Simeon is fouled. Simeon from Norwalk, Connecticut. Four, 14 out of 18 at the foul line.
Talk to your buddy.
And Simeon gets two. Southern Maine thinks they put the foul on the wrong person. On the board, it's against Luke Briggs. Martinotti into Vasquez. Vasquez fakes, drives, powers his way up and in. Nice drive by Randy Vasquez, the 6'5 sophomore from Methuen, Mass. Birmingham out to Pollock, swings it near side to Caldwell. Birmingham stops, fakes a three. Caldwell will take the three, back rim. Offensive rebound, Pollock. Reset the 20 seconds for the Mustangs. Birmingham bounce pass to Simeon. 10 to shoot. Simeon has to go to Caldwell. Caldwell on a drive through traffic, and that was blocked by Savage. Kamen Warburton comes out of the corner, goes to the other side, and there's a block by Harry Bates. The drive was by Adam Savage.
Savage making an immediate impact here for the Seawolves as a freshman out of Skowhegan High School.
He's listed as 6'7".
Led the football team to a state championship, multi-sport athlete for the River Hawks.
Yep. Warburton gets it out to Vasquez. Further out to Savage. Savage on a drive, little contact, we play on. Three-pointer out of the corner by Briggs. No good. Rebound battled for. Seawolves get it back. Another rebound for Southern Maine. Out to Savage on a drive. Warburton for three. Rattles off. A little volleyball action. Seawolves get it again. Warburton shoots, misses, rebound. Simeon, but he loses it.
Mustangs can't find the handle on the ball.
Savage trying to find somebody. Out to Martinotti. Savage looking things over. 10 to shoot, Seawolves. Warburton drives, high off the glass, no good. Rebound, Harry Bates. Here's Birmingham. Birmingham didn't play against Washington County, but he looks fine tonight. Pollock cuts through traffic. Vasquez with a steal. Seawolves quickly in the front court. Warburton over to Vasquez. Martinotti fakes a three, takes it, bang. Thomas Martinotti from Harwinton, Connecticut. Turnover, Mustangs. That was the 13th three by Thomas Martinotti, who's a junior.
Yeah, we saw him in the tournament here last year in the...
Yes.
Really having an outstanding tourney.
Sort of a...
He's a great player.
Yeah, coming out player, game for him.
Yeah. Just, he's continued with this year.
Simeon down deep, fakes one way, goes back the other. Air ball grabbed out of the air by Simeon. Hands off to Birmingham. Here come the Mustangs, trailing by three. Here's a drive. Birmingham goes all the way, comes up short. Birmingham got his own rebound. Pollock baseline jumper. Good! Jackson Birmingham worked very hard for that second possession.
Yeah, had the good take, got the rebound, got it to Pollock for the little baseline pop. Everything contested both ways here.
Oh, yes. Adam Savage to Vasquez. Peeks over his shoulder, goes the other way. Martinotti on the drive. And they're going to call illegal screen against Randy Vasquez.
Thinking the lineup that the Mustangs want to use tonight, I think probably going to see Wyatt Hathaway. They're going to want to bring him in probably for some energy and some shooting off the bench. Expect to see him shortly, I think, Jim.
They just look over your shoulder.
Yeah, thanks, Jim.
Are you mic'd? You might have been mic'd the other way. Instead of the coach mic, you're mic'd to him. Birmingham down there. Goes to the left hand. Or Harry Bates, I beg your pardon. Our friends down under, Harry Bates. The freshman from Port Macquarie. Mustangs a one-point lead. Martinotti has a knock from behind Jackson Birmingham. And here comes Rob Munzing subbing Patton as Wyatt Hathaway checks in for Cam Pollock.
See the Knights Bates move underneath. Faked right, went left, knocked it home.
Comes in, there's the fall away, is good.
Boy.
Adam Savage, excellent execution by the Seawolves.
That was a tough shot.
They lead by one. Bates, a cutting Caldwell, blocked by Savage. Caldwell, hook shot, no good. Here comes Adam Savage heading the other direction. He stops, gives up his dribble, finds Martinotti. Vasquez sets the screen. Halfway through the shot clock, Seawolves. Baseline catch for Vasquez. He fakes. And they're going to call a foul on Birmingham. First foul of the game against Central Maine.
Yeah, Birmingham trying to take the offensive charge, but called a block.
Coming in for the Mustangs, number 12, Colin Wilson, 6'4", sophomore from Norfolk, Connecticut.
Yeah, good underneath player, and we've seen him really sky for things.
Here's the long step by Briggs. He comes up short. Birmingham looks down court. Caldwell for three, short. Rebound went right in the hands of Martinotti. Here's the drive by Briggs. And let's see, score the basket. Luke Briggs. Sophomore from Augusta, Coney High School.
Briggs known for his outside shooting, but he can take it to the rack as well, as you're going to see here on this one. Nice finish by Briggs. The little hesitation goes left side.
Going for the old-fashioned three-point play, Luke Briggs. He's an 89% foul shooter and just went over 90%.
Yeah, he's a sharp shooter. Saw him a lot in high school covering Central Maine basketball.
Cole Polkinen in, number two for Southern Maine. Also 33, Ben Mullett. 10-6, Southern Maine. Wilson swings it around the left side. Pollock for three, comes up short. Wilson keeps it alive. Caldwell turns, shoots, and got it!
Credit Wilson's athletic play on the boards. Remember I told you he's coming in with a purpose to rebound. Got a defensive rebound within 2 seconds. Kept that play alive. Got the ball to Caldwell for two.
You're on point again. Here's a steal. Simeon going to take it all the way. Blocked. Excellent block by Adam Savage. Charlie Houghton coming in, number 22. 6'5", freshman from Dixfield, Darago High School. He's come on strong lately off the bench, Charlie
yes.
Houghton.
Charlie had a great high school career. Saw him on some Munson Media games, playing some games at Haldale High School. Rocco Chang in as well.
There's a drive shut off, and Colin Wilson rolls it in. Yeah, Rocco Chang, number 13, 6'4 freshman from Auckland. We're tied at 10.
This game's off with a faint.
Cole Polkinen, across the lane, gonna go scoop, a little heavy. Rebound, Rocco Chang. Caldwell to Pollock, Pollock backs, Pollock shoots, spins off, inside rebound. Nice position, Adam Savage. Savage will bring it up across the timeline. Savage says, I'm gonna take it all the way. Rebound was by Ben Muller to keep it alive from the corner. No good by 22, Charlie Houghton. 7 minutes in, Central Maine, Chang to Caldwell. Pollock gives it to Caldwell. Halfway through the shot clock, Mustangs. Bounce pass to Wilson. Caldwell has it way out top to Hathaway. Seven to shoot. Hathaway wants a screen. He got one. Hathaway comes up shooting off the rim. Rebound Savage and a foul. Liam O'Neill will check in for Southern Maine, number 20, 6'4 sophomore, Hudson, New Hampshire. Martin Audi returns. For the Mustangs, 15, Logan Myers is in. He's also from Port Macquarie, Australia. Where again, I think it's noontime on Thursday in Australia. I keep track of these and hope I don't goof it up too much. Polkinen from Heber, Maine. He's an Oxford Hills product. 11, Jay Hawks from Poland, Poland, but he went to Gray New Gloucester. Both coaches going to the bench early and often. On the drive, Hawks, he spins, takes it into traffic. Contact down there, and then lost out by the Seawolves. Twelve minutes remaining, first half, we're tied at 10 in the women's game in a hard fought one. Central Maine came back in the late going to beat Southern Maine 60-57. Down deep, Hathaway shut off. Goes out front, a three-pointer. No good by Chang. Batted around, grabbed out of the air by Polkinen. Martinotti swings it over to Houghton. Houghton drives, Chang defending. Martinotti for three, short. Rebound one right to Chang off the floor. Here's a three-pointer, Hathaway. We get contact. It might be three shots, Rob. Southern Maine bench.
They wanted a flop.
Yep. They weren't enthused about the call.
We'll see the end of it here. You see what you think at home.
Hathaway, an 86% foul shooter.
They're still hot on it over at the bench, yeah.
Now, I know Hathaway's a perimeter shooter, but he's only gone to the line 14 times coming in here, which seems low to me. You know, because he handles the ball a lot. Two out of three that time. Hathaway for three! I thought he was going to have a five-point play. Finally, the ball went to Martinotti. Martinotti directing a little traffic. Birmingham in the area. Jay Hawks on the far side. Out top to Polkinen. Polkinen shut off. Polkinen tries a hook shot, and somehow it went down. So he had to create the last second and give him credit for the play on a 12-12 tie. Birmingham dishes off underneath. And it was Logan Myers who came in baseline and gently put it over the side rim.
Birmingham made that on the...
Whoa, what a block! Harry Bates, how do you do? And it went off. Did it go off a Seawolf? Is that what happened, Rob? Or the...
I'm trying to make the replay on it, Jim. We'll save that one for later, and we'll be able to see what happened.
Southern Maine thought it was a tie-up. I saw the excellent block. Myers rotates in the corner to Chang. Hathaway on a drive, comes out the other side. Three-pointer, no good. That was missed by Myers. Martinotti across the top of the arc, looks for help, finds Polkinen. Polkinen gives up his dribble. Luke Briggs, 15 to shoot, no problem yet for Southern Maine. They go inside, the fall away. Martinotti goes down on a soft shot.
Got the roll.
Halfway through this first half, we're tied at 14. Chang through traffic. And the fouls will be non-shooting. Three fouls on the Mustangs, four on Southern Maine. Ball comes way out. Birmingham went way out to Hathaway. There's a drive coming in from the left side and laying it in. Jackson Birmingham.
Beautiful finish by Jackson. Euro step through.
People in Queensland like that one. They went to Sunshine Coast. He's in every stat line you can imagine at near the top in the league. 2-point lead. Mustangs behind his back. Briggs. Contact in the lane. Going to be foul shots.
Here's a Birmingham drive. You're going to see he gets it from Hathaway. Makes a little back cut. Wyatt reads it well. Very athletic play up and through. Well, we welcome all the people watching in New Zealand. It's Thursday. It's at 2:20 p.m.
Is it? I knew. I had around noontime. Of course, we changed the clock a few weeks ago. That also, yeah, you know, changes that.
I can't keep up with all those.
I know.
Things, Jim.
Spring ahead, fall
too
back.
Old,
you know that?
What is it? Spring ahead, fall back.
Yeah.
I limp around, so I don't know.
The foul shot is good by Luke Briggs.
Yeah, we got a good old-fashioned taffy pull going on here. Low score, 9:25 left first half. We've got 16 to 15 the score.
Luke Briggs now with that make is over 90% on the season. And that one halfway down. Rebound Savage. And then I think they call another foul. Fouls on Logan Myers, his first.
Troy Birmingham says, oh, way to go, Jackson. Yeah. Thanks for watching, Troy.
Martinotti for three.
Sweet.
Bang.
He's a sweet operator, isn't he?
Lead back to the Southern Maine, 18 to 16. Birmingham hands off to Caldwell. Birmingham got it back. Birmingham for three. Rebound Savage. Excellent position. He's a strong player, Rob, as you saw him.
Oh, boy, he's...
Vasquez dribbling, being guarded by Eli Bigelow, who's checked in for the Mustangs. From Lewiston. 10 to shoot, Seawolves. Briggs fakes. Briggs tries to create. Comes up short. Rebound grabbed out of the air by Jackson Birmingham. Malik Foster trying to get the lead, hits the rim. Caldwell with the rebound. Malik Foster, number four, is from Lewiston. Birmingham shut off and travels. Now, I want to know what's on the menu for lunch that the folks in Australia and New Zealand had. I'm not teasing. I like to know this stuff. What would be a lunch going into watching the game from the States?
Well, we'll see if anybody answers online there, Jim. Maybe they could have it delivered here to Kirk Hall. We'll get it. We'll get it next Monday.
No, I'm truly interested in They're calling a blocking foul against the Mustangs. Eli Bigelow picks up the foul. Dave Gagne was undecided.
Dave's trying to get an explanation.
Well, I think one of the CM students was asked to leave by the referee.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Cayman Warburton makes the foul shot. He's from Worcester. Trying to make it a four-point lead. And he does. Jackson Birmingham brings it up. Simeon back in the game. Foster skips it to the far side. Birmingham fakes the three. Birmingham drives. Score the basket. Plus one. Coach Richard said he's been in a number of grinder games this year. They made a nice comeback against Great Bay at Portsmouth. And he said up at Farmington, we lost on a last second basket to Division III Farmington. And who beat him? His former player, Zach Mickle.
So you saw the Birmingham finish there. That's right. Yeah, we saw Zach playing down here when we did the game down here.
Nice job by Birmingham. Cuts it to one. So
Zach and her brother, his older brother, both good players.
One-point game. Seawolves with the lead in the basketball. Warburton shut off. Vasquez gives it back to Warburton. Pollock playing defense, but somehow Cayman Warburton found a crease and laid it in. 7.5 to go, first half. Mustangs trailing by three. Pollock swings it left side. Birmingham gets a screen. Birmingham stops. Nice angle off the glass. Jackson Birmingham. Sam Jones, Hall of Fame player of the Celtics, would like that.
Josh Gentry seeing his first appearance in this game. It's good to have Josh back.
Number 33 from London, UK. A little hook shot by Savage. His time is good. We haven't seen Josh Gentry for weeks, have we?
High ankle sprain coming off that. Saw Josh. He was the first one in the gym when I got here. He said, I'm playing tonight. He was excited. We're excited for Josh. Good kid.
Hope people in UK enjoy the coverage. Fall away Simeon, a little too strong.
Yeah, Josh might be a good matchup here for some of the underneath. Savage has been really effective.
Almost lost, but the Seawolves saved the possession. Still have plenty of time to shoot. Vasquez backs in. He was triple teamed, and then the Mustangs lost it out. Shot clock at 10.
They're only leaving the clock at 10, saying the Mustangs really never possessed.
They're going to talk it over.
They're going to see whether or not they I think you need a possession, see if there was a possession.
I think there's another fan that maybe has to leave.
Don't swear. You can yell or scream, don't swear. You understand? Don't swear.
Oh, we had Dave's mic up, but that's good to hear. He says you can yell and scream, but don't swear. Dave carries a lot of power around here, and the kids will they'll respond to that.
Yeah, he really didn't want to put his athletic director's hat on, but he had to for a few seconds.
Yeah. Well, once Dave got the way, he says, I'll take care of it. Mission accomplished. That'll be the end of it.
All right, sideline inbounds play for the Seawolves. Savage will inbound. Warburton, eight to shoot. Martinotti, fall away from three. Went wide, but Vasquez got it, and it's going to be a shot clock violation. It never drew iron.
Well, Mustangs lucked out there, Jim, because they had two or three guys underneath and not able to get the ball away. It came to Savage. That wasn't Savage. Vasquez.
Birmingham out front. Gentry. DePaulick. Caldwell for three. Back rim. Simeon kept it alive. Somehow Simeon got it. In traffic. He puts it in. What a sequence for Jeremiah Simeon. He did the hard work, and he was rewarded by getting a basket to cut the lead to one. Warburton watched closely by Pollock. Martinotti in the far side. Savage goes way out front to Warburton. Caldwell defending. Warburton hits the back rim on a three. And look at Birmingham climb the ladder. He leads the break. Caldwell thought about it. Caldwell now shoots. A little too long. Weak side rebound, Savage.
Yeah, Boston just can't get that rhythm down, but keep humming.
Savage all the way to the corner. Martinotti thought about a three. Now he takes a three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound, Caldwell. He's going to slow it down. It was a one-on-three break, so good decision by Caldwell. Simeon in the right corner. Out front to Birmingham. Pollock left of the foul line extended. There's a screen by Gentry. Pollock through traffic, fakes, stops, swish! What a smart play by Cam Pollock. He took his time, came up with about an 8-foot shot, and the Mustangs take the lead. 4.5 minutes to go, first half. Martinotti needs help. Warburton almost by midcourt. 10 to shoot. They go down to Vasquez. He's double-teamed. Here's a three-pointer. Savage spins off. Rebound, Gentry. Wow.
Good half-court defense.
Birmingham looks over his shoulder to Coach Gagne. His assistant, Steve Carey, Jared Rubin, Corey David, Malik Farley. Bang! Boston Carwell from downtown Auburn. Timeout Seawolves, 3:52 to go in the half. Central Maine 28, Southern Maine 24 on Munzing Media Sports.
Well, let's take a look at that sequence. Big one for the Mustangs. They dug in on the D, then got down, got the opportunity. We told you, Caldwell needs to keep shooting, and that's exactly what he's going to do here as we take a look at the play run through. Got a timeout so we can run it for a while. You see the kick out, the penetration kick out. Boston in the corner, lets it rip. Knocks it home. Let's see what the huddle's like. Yeah, we're not able to bring up Dave's mic. He might have slipped into his pocket there. We'll fix that at halftime, get that reconstructed there. But this is a good little sequence for the Mustangs, Jim, up by four.
You had Jeremiah Simeon involved with one, and then Cam Pollock, who took a pass from somebody I couldn't see from here. But that was a nice play by Pollock. He took his time and got a good look. Let's see. Still six fouls on CM. Five on Southern Maine.
Good pickup by Joe Nelson, our camera kid. He said the reason he couldn't pick Dave up, he wasn't talking in the huddle that time. Coach Coach David was talking.
All right, cancel the order for the new microphone then.
Thanks, Joe. All right. Joe Full Nelson. Way to go, Joe.
That's kind of cool. The guy with the microphone wasn't talking.
The best laid plans.
All right. Martinotti off balance, and it stays down.
Oh, boy, what a finish by Martinotti. He's a special player.
Excellent defense by the Mustangs, but Martinotti, nice soft touch. Two-point Mustang lead. Caldwell out the top to Bates on the far side. That's Pollock. Pollock shut off. They have to skip it all the way over here. Here goes Chang. Chang dumps it back to the other side. Around and good for Pollock.
That's almost impossible to shoot that shot like that and have it act like that. He's from behind the basket, rolling around the rim and in.
How'd that ball from one side to the other the way it did? They did it twice. Came this side through traffic, went back to the other side through traffic. 4 points. Jump shot, Warburton, nothing but net.
Yeah, Warburton just took over on that offensive possession for the Seawolves.
2:40 on a moving clock. Mustangs by two. Again, as the women's game, this one as advertised. It's good for the schools. It's good for the YSCC. It's good for the basketball. Chang comes up short. Warburton somehow saved it in to Martinotti.
Yeah, hard down there, too.
Martinotti gives up his dribble. Savage comes out to help. Plenty of time on the clock to shoot. Savage wants to go to work. He's going to fall away three.
Oh,
bang.
My. My.
31-30, Seawolves with 2 minutes to go.
That's a big boy three.
Yes. All of it was under control the whole time. Caldwell to Chang. Hathaway for three. Spins off. Rebound Vasquez. Here go the Seawolves. Mustangs get back. Savage to Martinotti. His Jayhawks back in the game, 11. 12 to shoot. Warburton in the paint, shut off. Vasquez, no good, but he's going to shoot two.
Here's that Savage three, Jim. As you said, under control. We got it back here. Watch him step back and just drill one home.
I'm guessing that was in his mind the whole time.
I think so.
Vasquez at the line. He'll get one more. Vasquez is a 73% foul shooter coming in. He's 0 for 2 that trip. Rebound, Simeon. Pollock brings it up in front of the SM bench. That's Hathaway. He's going to dribble out front. Baseline pass on the other side is Pollock. He rattles off inside position Vasquez. Gave it to Warburton. Warburton in the paint, tries to create. I guess he created. Semi-hook shot off glass, Rob.
Got up and said, okay, now what am I going to do? And like great scorers do, he found a way.
33-30, Seawolves. Caldwell shut off. Simeon swings it over to the left of the foul line, extended Hathaway. Colin Wilson in the game, sets the screen. Hathaway for three. Bang! And Hathaway's fired up along with the Central Maine bench. We have a tie game. Shot clock is off.
Should
game
be.
Clock at 20. Coach Richards calling the play. Martinotti. 8 seconds. Martinotti spins. Fall away Martinotti is good. What a play. Shot clock running down, and the Seawolves take the lead right at the buzzer. It was quite a first half of action, folks. At the half in this YSCC State of Maine matchup. It's Southern Maine Community College 35, Central Maine Community College 33. We'll come back in a few minutes with some halftime stats on Munzing Media Sports. Thank you.
At Central Maine Community College, we are building things that last. We're investing in technology, new facilities, and offering more degree programs than ever before. You can get the traditional college experience at a fraction of the cost. And for some, it's even free.
Wait. Did she just say free?
That's right, free tuition for Maine high school grads from 2020 through 25. Set your goals and find your path at CM. Let's build a future together.
When I walked through these doors, I was just blown away.
This is insane. It just caught my attention immediately.
This is the first place that I've seen like this decked out. It's pretty sweet.
This is a grand opening for our esports arena. We're talking 1,600 square feet of pure technology.
Like, I'm shaking being here. It's so cool.
There's nothing like it in Maine. We're ahead of the curve here.
It's definitely a big market, something you can make a living on.
I've always had an interest in esports.
We're treating it like an extension of our athletic program. And then in addition to that, we're starting an esports management degree program.
It's just a different community for me to be a part of.
It really just helps me just be myself. It's just really fun.
This will bring students together. That's what's happening, and that's what esports is.
To me, it's beautiful, and I want to live here.
Provides our program exactly what they say, a chance for small colleges to compete. It's leveling the playing field for everybody.
Brand advisor and CEO of Pliable. Pliable helps high school, college, and professional athletes build their athlete brand. New name, image, and likeness opportunities are a game changer for athletes and for businesses. To learn more about social media marketing and endorsement opportunities for your brand, visit PliableMarketing.com or call 1-707-PLIABLE.
Same thing as always.
That's look,
the front of the net.
All those little things to make you what you are.
Jim, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3,
zero.
Okay, let's go.
1, 2, 3.
You sit right here.
Helping people is kind of ingrained into me. I am so glad that I chose to be here. It's a really great program.
Primary dental's in the heart.
The instructors are super helpful.
They really do set you up to be successful in the field.
The new hospital simulation lab here at CMCC is a great addition.
It's as close to replicating real life as you can get.
We did an IV lab.
With a mannequin, it's nice to get your toes wet before you jump into a clinical setting.
Deep breath.
CMCC is the best place to start nursing.
It's challenging, but you are learning.
We have a smaller size classroom, smaller ratio to instructors.
It's affordable.
It really provided me relief that I'm not going to accrue a lot of debt.
I needed to set myself and my family up for success after.
I'm going to come out of this able to actually practice as an RN in the real field. It's a wonderful opportunity.
Forensics has grown so much, and it's very beneficial to the criminal justice system. I was always one of those kids that watched Forensic Files. That was something I loved. Just science person all around, I always have been. The instructors are some of the top forensic experts in Maine. They really know what they're talking about. They've been there, done that. CMCC is very lucky to have people like this. I'm an intro to criminal justice and criminal law report writing. That's a lot of the baseline of things I have to be knowledgeable about. I want to do crime scene photography. The forensic science program is preparing me to start thinking, like, what's important here? What do I need to look for, like, right off the bat? You never know what you're gonna find.
We're joined here at halftime by Coach Morong, as you see on the graphic. 300 wins, Coach. Congratulations on that. What a milestone that is.
Yeah, thank you. It's just a marker of longevity more than anything else, that's for sure.
Well, what a game against the arch rivals, too. I mean, these things, you know, as a former coach, I know we have such tunnel vision as coaches, and it's sometimes very difficult to appreciate the moment. This is one of those things that when you're my age, and in a lot of years, you'll look back on this and think, God, that was a special night. It really was. It was a comeback win against our rivals for 300, huh?
Yeah, you know, and it does hit me as special. Just, you know, my kids were here, my wife, my parents, my sister watching online. And then just the way the kids played in such true CM fashion in that fourth quarter. Just blue collar, roll up my sleeves, I'm going to outwork you, and I don't care what the scoreboard says. I'll take as many of those games as I can get, because that's, it's just special to share the moment, and then to have Destiny do what she did. You know, I'm probably harder on her than I've ever been any other player in the history of this program. And to have her respond in such a pivotal way, in such a pivotal moment, just so proud of that kid. You know, she's a kid that 20 years from now, her and I are going to be closer than we are right now. And I'm just so incredibly proud of her.
Well, Jim Toomey points out quite regularly about the quality of your coaching during timeouts.
Yeah, I like the fact, Coach Morong, some coaches say too much. They say about 8 or 10 things. You're very concise. You're very calm.
Yeah.
And I was the little things like, okay, we have plenty of timeouts. Use it if you have to. Now, take the timeout because we want to move it to the front court. You know, we have the arrow. So don't have to foul anybody, just tie him up.
Right.
And you do it in sort of a methodical way, and I think they comprehend it. And instead of some coaches saying too many things.
Yeah, I think a lot of coaches, and I get caught up in it too sometimes, we overcoach, right? And it's so easy to do, but we've been in so many of these moments, you know, and I have been in so many of these moments over the last 12 years. You just got to be calm, right? If I'm yanked up, the girls are going to be yanked up. And if they're yanked up, they're more likely to make a mistake, right? And you just got to be calm. And, I mean, my demeanor in the first half, you know, I'm a little on the psychotic side and loud and in their face. And then as that game goes on, I kind of wind myself down. And I have to regroup myself because I know that's what they need. But, like, how play, like, look at the girls we had. We had 3 freshmen out there for most of that fourth quarter, you know? And, like, Chantel Ouellette is the toughest kid I have ever coached in my entire life, and I don't think I could ever coach a kid tougher than her. The way she just sacrifices her body, sacrifices her stats to make us a better program and a better team, she makes my job easy. I just look at Shani, her and I make eye contact. She's a woman of very few words, and we just know exactly what we're thinking. We're always on the same page. And then look at, you know, Yolene DeFort. Man, Joe, she played probably 35 minutes tonight. Not one single peak, not one single valley. It was just steady. And it was nothing extraordinary other than just pure effort. And her defense on that last possession, there was no way she was letting Maddie York, who's a terrific basketball player, get that shot off, you know. Yeah.
And that's what you talked about in the huddle, Coach. You said, don't give 24 a look. You know, and she took it right to heart. And Yolene at times playing one of the premier point guards in the YSCC and in the nation. Hope Butler, terrific ball handler, stayed right with her.
Yeah, 5'11", wow. You know, Yolene. I mean, she's going to be playing basketball on a full scholarship somewhere real soon, you know. There's going to be plenty of coaches at the Division I, Division II, NAIA levels that would be lucky to have her. And we're lucky to have her right now. She is just such a hard worker, and she's such a great teammate. She's so coachable. And she's not even scratching the surface yet. Before her time here is done, she will have a prolific career. I would, you can take that to the bank.
Yeah. You know, one of the things I said to Jim during the broadcast, Coach, you pick the, you take the three teams, you know, you, the Sea Wolves, and the Moose at the women's, you know, you throw them in a hat, shake them up, and, you know, who knows what's going to happen down the road with this because, you know, these are three really good competitive teams.
Yeah, I think all three are better than most D3 teams in the state, not going to lie. I know that sounds a little forward, but it is. There's some really good basketball, and people don't realize it. I think this CMSM rivalry, this game right here, this environment, show me where this is replicated at the Division III level or any other level in the state of Maine. It's not. You know, this is really special on both men's and women's side. To have so many alumni come back, so many people from the community come out and show support from this for our teams. It's just really special. We're very lucky to have this, you know.
Well, we're very lucky to have you here as our halftime guest, Coach. Congratulations on the 300 wins. Glad
your
family could be here. I saw you run over, grab one of the little ones, pull them up in the air. And, boy, that tugs at my heart because I had that opportunity to do that a few times. Nothing like having your family involved.
Nothing like it. Thank you guys for all that you guys do as well. We didn't until you guys came up before the game and someone asked me, we had no idea
Jim
that tonight
Toomey.
Was going to be 300.
You credit this man sitting right here for his prep work that is beyond extraordinary.
That's awesome.
Jim came in, the first thing he said, hey, I added up Coach Morong's wins. He's at 299. I wonder if they're going to do something. Well, nobody knew it until Jim started spreading the word. Well, Jim didn't do it. I did. I took the forefront to do that. Great work, Jim.
Well, with simple math, Coach Morong's bio was revised this summer.
Said
he had 289 wins.
Yeah.
Okay, we had 10 coming in, and wait a minute, 11 plus equals 300.
Easy math right there. Even I can do that.
There we go. You're going to get a good score on your SATs, Mr. Toomey. Good job on that
Thank
math.
Thank you, guys.
You're All welcome. Right, Thank you, Coach.
All right, great interview, Rob. Want to do some stats?
Yep.
Okay, we're just going to do individual. For the Seawolves, Cayman Warburton has 8. Luke Reeks, 4 points. Thomas Martinotti hit that buzzer beater to give the Seawolves the lead. He's in double digits with 12. 2 points for Randy Vasquez. Adam Savage, 7 points and 5 rebounds. 2 points for Cole Polkinen. And that was the scoring for the Seawolves. They did shoot 43% from the floor, I will say that. Central Maine Mustangs, Cam Pollock with 6. Jeremiah Simeon, 4 points. 5 points for Boston Caldwell. 7 for Jackson Birmingham. Harry Bates with a basket for 2. You see, off the bench, Wyatt Hathaway, 5 points. 2 points for Colin Wilson. Also 2 points for Logan Myers. The Mustangs shot 38% from the floor. Let's see, both teams having trouble behind the arc, Rob. Seawolves 3 out of 11, Mustangs 2 out of 14. Foul shooting 4 out of 7, Southern Maine, 5 out of 6, Central Maine. Let's see, nobody in any trouble. Nobody has more than 2 fouls. 8 fouls were called on the Mustangs, 5 on the Seawolves.
And there's been some physical play. I mean, you get guys in here tonight with the whistles that they get it, you know. They understand how this game's going to be played, and they're doing a terrific job of it. Of course, you don't agree with every call if you're a coach or a player, but you know these guys are giving you the effort.
35-33, Southern Maine leading at the half. Again, in the women's game, it was tough the whole game. Southern Maine had the lead. I'm going to say a majority of the game, strong fourth quarter for the Mustangs. And Coach Morong got his 300th victory, 60-57.
There goes that academic scholarship we're talking about.
I know. And he didn't mention to the players, nobody, I mean, that's how low-key he was going to be.
Nobody knew. Jim Toomey knew.
Well, thank you for following up on it, Rob. Seawolves have trouble with it. Now that goes back out to Martinotti. Out by the Mustangs logo. Jackson Birmingham is watching him. Here's Savage. Savage left-handed. He loses the dribble picked off the floor by Boston Caldwell. Let's see what The Mustangs do with their first possession of the second half. Birmingham directs a little traffic. Goes down to Harry Bates. Bates working baseline. Simeon stops, shoots, does not get the roll. Simeon climbs the ladder once, twice, three times. Simeon works. Pollock comes up short. Pollock the rebound. Caldwell for three. Off the unbelievable. Unbelievable sequence.
And all for naught as far as the points are concerned, but it's kind of effort you want to see.
You were hoping for a punctuation mark at the end of it. That could be a misleading offensive rebound stat. You got like four offensive rebounds.
Exactly. Exactly.
Warburton. Vasquez peeks over his shoulder. Warburton tees one up. Rattles off. The tip, no good. Coming away with it is Pollock. Down in the corner, Simeon. Caldwell with a little room. No good. Rebound off the floor to Warburton, and it's going to be a blocking foul right by the scorer's table. Jackson Birmingham, teammates looking at him, and they help him up.
That's two quick fouls on Birmingham, though. That's his third.
Yes, yes. Coach Gagne, you have a decision to make early in the second half.
Joe, give me a little more height on the basket, okay, from now on? Just a little more height.
Vasquez being guarded by Bates. They rotate it around, Savage to Warburton. Vasquez powers his way. A baby hook shot. That was blocked and taken away by Harry Bates. Harry Bates with good D.
Well, good D here so far. Start the second half. Yeah. First 2 minutes, nobody can score.
Bates. Pollock stops, shoots, got it. We're tied at 35, 2 minutes into the second half. It's great schedule makers that have this game, the last one of the semester, and then at the end of the year, I believe a lot of times it's the last game of the season. Savage for three. Bang. That Savage shows up in many different places, doesn't he?
He sure does, yeah. He's a great all-around player and a tremendous multi-sport athlete in high school.
Birmingham. On the far side, Simeon. Simeon drives, has it deflected. And let's see, they're going to call a foul on Simeon, I think, for jumping in. And players are pushing each other. It was sort of a pileup, and some of the other players came in, and I'm not sure that's helping, trying to push their teammate off the pile, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, then. No double dating going on here tonight with these guys, you know what I mean? They're rivals for a reason. Getting after it.
On Simeon. Vasquez goes underneath to the baseline area. Savage, fall away, no good. Rebound, Harry Bates.
It came to Simeon, he was on his backside.
Pollock in front of the CM student section skips it to Hathaway for three. It sort of looked short and proved to be short, Rob. Luke Briggs picks up the foul. His third.
Remember that disputed foul at the side of the game, Jim, that they didn't think should have gone to Briggs.
That's right. Jay Hawks in for the Seawolves, number 11. Into Bates, the turnaround hook shot, no good. Rebound, Savage. Savage puts it in high gear. No good. How he kept his balance and foot down, I don't know. Pollock outlet to Caldwell for three. Back rim, rebound Bates. Caldwell down deep, Pollock the jump shot. He hits the back rim. Rebound Martinotti. Hawks. Outside, here's Savage, a deeper three. That rattles off, grabbed off the floor by Hathaway. Pollock walks it up. And it's going to be a timeout. Central Maine, 15:51 to go, second half. Southern Maine leads 38-35.
Yeah, both teams struggling on offense here.
You good with Jay?
You okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
do I need one?
Yeah.
Huh?
Wait, what?
We're in the huddle.
Yeah.
Colin?
Your call.
Colin, check in, quick.
Okay, we're going into the zone now. All right? Let's go in the zone now. So you two are underneath. Hands in the middle. You two are on the wings now. Extend on the wings now. You understand? On the other end, make good decisions now. You're working your ass off down there. I like it. Now, who's got Savage? Stay on your feet. Keep him in front of you, okay? Don't let him muscle you. Muscle back. Let's go. Let's go. Hey.
So you're going to see the Mustangs go into zone, which they don't play a lot. I don't want to say it too loud. Coach Richardson right next to us.
I know.
He'll figure it out soon enough. Well, we hope you're enjoying this. Boy, we've had a great season up to now, covering all our sports here at Central Maine Community College. It's going to end it for the semester. But, boy, what a ride it's been with all the great fall action and the winter action going great.
We won't see basketball here till the middle of January. Yeah. I think they go on the road for a couple of games coming out of the break.
Yeah.
And thanks, everybody, for their feedback. Wherever you're watching and listening, it's all about the student-athletes keeping the connection to the homeland. Hathaway for three, high off the rim. Colin Wilson was in the game. He skied but couldn't control it.
Yeah, they picked up the zone.
Martinotti over to Hawks, left of the foul line extended. From the outside, somebody took the shot. I had the coach and referee blocking me on that one. Rebound. But Pollock has it.
Who can get hot for the Mustangs, huh, Jim? Who's going to get hot?
Tough defense by the Seawolves. Bates baseline, looks over his shoulder. In the lane, tries to create. He goes up, comes up short. Mustangs have had a lot of shots coming up short.
Vasquez playing like a man inside, Jim. Tough guy.
He is. Hawks on the far side. Returns the pass to Martinotti. 10 to shoot, Seawolves. Savage in the paint. Savage the fall away. No, but I think Adam Savage will shoot two.
What was the score at the half, Jim? What we've got about 5-7 points scored here in the second?
Score at the half was 35-33 SM. So 3 points for SM, 2 for the Mustangs.
5 points.
Yeah. At the line, Savage came in shooting 75%.
Got the first one there.
His first attempt tonight. Savage goes 2 for 2. That trip to 5 point Seawolves lead. Pollock will be picked up by Hawks. In front of his own bench, Hathaway looks underneath. Nothing there. He's into the paint, needs help. Somehow got it out to Wilson, who quickly returns it to Hathaway. Pollock, 10 to shoot. Pollock, the turnaround. No good. Nice rebound. That was Charlie Houghton who just checked in. Baseline, Vasquez back outside. This is going to be a backcourt. No, I guess it was deflected.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, Chang got a piece of it.
All right. 10 to shoot. Pollock playing D. Martinotti in the middle to Hawks. Vasquez, the jump shot, rattles off. And the tip-in. I think that was Houghton, right? 22?
Houghton's 22. Yep.
Yes.
Charlie came in with the tip.
6'5", first year from Dixfield, Maine, as we mentioned in the first half.
Birmingham going to check back in. Remember, he went out with three fouls early.
Yeah, you can't wait. 7-point deficit Mustangs. Deflected pass goes to Bates. And now they deflect it for a steal. Seawolves was in quick hands. Savage in the front court. Out to Martinotti. Thought about it. Backs off. Martinotti with 10 to shoot. Looking for something. Has to go to Savage. Here's Hawks for three. No good. Rebound bounces around. Savage ends up with it. Shot clock went to 20. Inside. Stolen away. Harry Bates ended up with it. Tough stand by the Mustangs, but Rob, they got to do something on this end of the court. Bates gave it to Pollock. Wilson in the far corner. Chang has it. Hathaway in front of his own bench. Martinotti's keeping his eyes right on Hathaway, who takes the three. Bang!
Needed that one.
Oh, big shot. Somebody set a screen, and Hathaway came up shooting. 42-38. Seawolves the lead in the basketball. Under 12 minutes remaining. Second half. Houghton stops. Martinotti for three. Bang! That barely tickled the net for a 45-38 lead.
Well, here's the Hathaway three coming off the screen. Knocks it home.
Three, the other two.
Okay, we're back to man now, one time. Back to man. I'll tell you when to get back to 32, okay? I don't give me fouls yet. You play hard. Run 22 in offense, all right? Yeah. And we know what they're doing.
Guys gotta move on 22. Can't be standing still.
Don't be a spectator. Rebound. All right, down here, bang away. Let's go. Let's go.
6 on 3, 10 on 6. 1, 2, 3. Okay. 5, 6.
Coach Dave in the huddle.
So for the Mustangs, it remains Birmingham, Wilson, Hathaway. Oh, Logan Myers has checked in, and Boston Caldwell is the fifth player. Adam Savage is going to take a break.
Yeah, he's played a lot of minutes tonight. He's probably been on the floor for most of the game.
One of the assistant coaches was talking to him singly. I'll tell you, he was locked on to the assistant coach. They gave each other a hug, but he was listening so intently. So I was impressed with that. Holding foul, Southern Maine. Cole Polkinen in, number two. Hebron, Maine, Oxford Hills. Third foul on Luke Briggs. Actually, no, second foul on Polkinen. Luke Briggs just came in. Myers, Hathaway in front of the student section. Hands off to Birmingham. Birmingham spins, gives up his dribble, skips it to Myers for three, rattles off, rebound grabbed off the floor by Ben Mullett from Hudson, New Hampshire, went to Bishop Garrison. Polkinen with the basketball. Hawks. That's Briggs. Underneath, Hawks drives, hung it on the rim, a rebound Myers. Birmingham through traffic, and they're gonna call traveling. In the NBA, he could have taken three more steps.
We got to credit the Seawolves defense, really dug in here in the second half, Jim. And Mustangs just need to stay at it, get somebody, get the hot hand.
That is true. 10.5 to go. Here's a shot, couldn't see by who. Here's Hathaway. Caldwell outside Myers for three. That one, front rim. Here comes Cole Polkinen. He goes all the way, got the back rim, rebound by Charlie Houghton, and he was fouled. Second foul on Myers. Liam O'Neill checking in. Ben Mellett will sit down. O'Neill from Hudson, New Hampshire. Went to Alburn. Out of bounds play from the baseline for the Seawolves, leading by seven. Halfway through the second half. Houghton. Briggs signaling the play. Briggs starts to drive. Shut off by Caldwell. Loose ball picked up by Birmingham. Birmingham coast to coast and lays it in.
Charlie, go, Charlie.
Defense into offense for the Mustangs. 45-40. Pulkkinen wants a screen. Gets one from O'Neill. Seawolves still got 15 to shoot. There's another turnover. And it's going to be a holding foul on Jay Hawks.
Yeah, that's a good foul by Hawks because it's going to be a lay-in for the Mustangs. They had two galloping up the court, Jim. That's a good foul.
Martin Naughty checks back in. I expect Adam Savage to be in soon, too. This went under 9.5 minutes remaining. Jim Toomey, along with our executive producer, Rob Munzing. Well, this Joe Nelson on the camera.
Similar to where we were in the women's game at this juncture.
Yes. Nice move by Simeon, but it wouldn't fall. 90% of that move was perfect to the very end. You don't mind if I call you executive producer, do you?
No. Okay. No. I'm going to give myself pay rate.
You'll get an extra cookie at home.
Yeah.
Martin Naughty backs out. Simeon defending. Five to shoot. Martin Naughty for three. Got the rim. Rebound Birmingham. Outlet to Caldwell. One on one. Caldwell forces the contact and got the soft roll. Boston Caldwell.
Boy, that was hotter than it looked, Jim.
I didn't think it was going to go. You know what I'm saying? Down to a three-point lead. Starters ready to go in. Houghton from outside, and no good. And climbing the ladder was Wyatt Hathaway.
Oh, down to one possession here, Jim.
Yes. Birmingham into the corner for three. Bang! There's the tie. There's your one possession.
There it is.
We're tied at 45. Write it down. It happened like at 8-10 remaining. Pulkkinen shut off. O'Neill with it. O'Neill trying to create. Back outside to Pulkkinen. Pulkkinen in the lane. Hathaway playing defense. O'Neill the fall away. Wide. Grabbed off the floor by Birmingham. Mustangs run the court. Caldwell off balance. And it stays down for Boston. Caldwell.
Well, very similar to the one he just had that I had ready for a replay.
Charlie Houghton aggressive move. They're going to call a foul on CM, I think. I want to see that. I would like to see that one. Simeon's getting the foul.
Here comes Boston Caldwell. What a finish by Boston. Wow. Well, one of the first leads of the night since early on, Jim, for sure.
Yes.
Two-point lead.
Okay, they say no shots. Foul was on Rocco Chang, his first. They finally get it out to Savage behind the arc. Martin Naughty faces the basket, fakes, shoots, rattles off. Rebound grabbed off the floor by Birmingham. Birmingham being guarded by Briggs. Birmingham out by the Mustangs logo. Looks over to head coach Dave Gagne. Birmingham spins into the lane. 3 points for Chang. Got all iron. A rebound Briggs. Just went under 7 minutes remaining in a two-point game.
Well, Hathaway went out. I don't think he's going to stay out long. He's had a hot hand here the second half. Probably got to get him in offensively, Jim.
Kamen Warburg gave it to Savage. Savage, a little change of pace, dribble, fires the three, comes up short. Vasquez had the rebound. The basket won't count, I don't think.
Yeah, I think it's going to be on the floor before.
It's going to be a one and one.
Yeah, it'll be, they'll be shooting, yes.
Seven fouls for CM against three. Harry Bates, third foul.
You missed the women's game. The Mustangs came back to win it. Destiny Mora-Lopez with a great finish. Coach Morong picks up his 300th win. Nobody moved.
And there's the rebound. It was a one and one. Who scored that basket?
Savage.
Was it Savage? Yeah, everybody was like, somebody hit the pause button. Tied at 47, 6:20 on a moving clock. Simeon. Birmingham thought about the three, tries to go baseline, comes up the other side, and somehow Kamen Warburton got inside position. Warburton forces the issue, threw it right to Rocco Chang. Rocco says, thank you very much. Here's Caldwell out of the corner. He spins, and he's going to be called for the foul or not? No.
No.
Well, I saw some Seawolves players clapping. Two shots for Boston Caldwell.
Well, we see Boston shoot outside a lot. Jimmy's an outdoor, outside bombardier for the Mustangs. But you know what's been the difference here in the second half for his game? What, not falling outside, taking it to the rack. He's got two great finishes. That was a great take. And he's got the first of what will be another foul shot coming up.
Came into tonight shooting just about 70%.
Well, I'm not sure how the final 6 minutes is going to play out here, 5:56, but boy, we've had a heck of a night of basketball here from Kirk. Oh, wow.
You know, sometimes you see a certain date or team on the schedule.
Yeah.
You look forward to it. You anticipate something, and it never happens for whatever reasons. You know, somebody is hurt or two players are hurt.
We're going the huddle here.
Guys, what is it? Right here. Who's the five of the game? Okay, you get out. Okay, on the zone. Hey, everybody rebounds offensively. Everybody checks out every time. Can we get something easy? Can we get up down the floor, please? As soon as he gets the ball, you guys are sprinting down the other end to get something easy now. All right? Straight into 3-2 now.
Next shift down, Jackson, Harry, Wyatt. Jackson, come off the double screen. Harry, float down. Wyatt, you pop. Wyatt, pop off the screen.
Got it?
You listen, Coach Corey David in the huddle.
We're playing timeouts if we get in trouble.
Hey.
Corey's got a long list of been there, done that.
Yes. Well, this is a great game. Hope you're enjoying it.
Around the state of Maine, around the country, and around the world on Munzing Media Sports. Want to say happy holidays around the world, however you celebrate your holidays. I hope the family is with you. Warburton. Martinotti looking underneath. Savage. Savage got position on the block. Got a little rim, but it was soft enough to go in. So we get a tie with 5.5 to go.
Well, why wouldn't we?
Chang out top to Birmingham looking underneath. Caldwell. Chang starts to drive, loses his balance, and I think he's going to the line.
Well, Chang with a spin move inside, off balance, drew the contact, put it up so he'd get two. Big game up in Augusta, and you can also check in on that game in Augusta, folks. That's on Munzing Media on Facebook. That's four fouls.
Who are the Moose playing, by the way?
They're playing Great Bay Community College. So the men's game going on right now, concurrently with this one. So all the games are on Munzing Media.
So Rocco Chang made the first one. And the second one.
Yeah, busy night for Munzing Media. And I got four games. I want to thank my sons, Andy and Nate, up in Augusta, getting that game out.
Yeah, whatever rivalries they have as brothers, when it comes on the microphone,
oh, they work great together.
Yeah. Just teasing. Out of the corner, a three-pointer rattles off. Offensive rebound off the miss of Briggs. That Vasquez, a great rebounder. Martinotti in the corner. Here comes another three. Bang! That was Luke Briggs.
Yeah, Luke's been a little quiet tonight. Remember getting that foul trouble, had to come out. He's playing what for, Jim?
1 point, Seawolves lead. Birmingham down deep, does not get the roll. Rebound, Vasquez.
Hey, Randy, keep going, Randy! Come on, good season.
Martinotti wants a screen. Martinotti, no good. Rebound, Vasquez, no! It defied gravity. Briggs from the outside. Bang! Another three-pointer by Luke Briggs. Fall away Caldwell. He's Ooh, got it.
That's a tough shot right there.
Big basket as we just went under 4 minutes.
Well, the offensive guys are stepping to the forward. Briggs for the Seawolves. Caldwell for the Mustangs.
Warburton. Defending is Hathaway. Warburton. Powers it up and in. He used a 6-2 frame to go inside with 3.5 to go and a 4-point Seawolves lead.
Yeah, 3 for 3, the last offensive takes for the Seawolves. Mustangs looking to duplicate that.
Caldwell stops, shoots.
He's the man.
He's got it.
Boston, he's our man. If he can't do it, no one can.
That's right.
The big guys are stepping up offensively. Walburton had that nice drive earlier.
Warburton has it now. Halfway through the shot clock, Seawolves. Briggs takes the hoop and scores the bucket, plus one. This has become the Luke Briggs show the last 2 minutes.
Got 8 points in the last 3 out of 4 possessions, Jim. This was a tough power. That's the one there. You're just seeing the end of the finish. Sorry about that. Didn't do a great job on the replay. Want to get back for the free throw, though.
He completes the three-point play. You see, Captain Obvious says this is a big possession. In the lane, deflected. Bates saves it. And look at Birmingham catch it. Caldwell for three. Bang! Boston Caldwell comes through again as his teammates saved the possession somehow to come within two.
Wow.
Vasquez sets the screen. They go the other way. Savage almost lost it. He backs in. And Savage is going for the old-fashioned three-point play.
Well, Savage just backed in. Went physical, knocked it home. Boy, we're getting some great play here in the last couple of minutes, both sides offensively. You know, it's been a struggle at times offensively, but boy, the last couple of executions for both sides have been really, really good.
No good by Savage, rebound Pollock. Two possession game. We count down, 2:15. Birmingham baseline, has it deflected. Birmingham got it back and somehow got a shot off. And here's, guess who? Luke Briggs takes the Euro step and lays it in. The Southern Maine fans on the other side get excited, as they should. Out top to Birmingham. Inside, Bates is bumped, I believe. This will be a non-shooting.
Yeah, 6 foul. Boy, Briggs has been something here, Jim. Wow. He's taken over this game offensively for the Seawolves. Getting the huddle with the Mustangs.
Wyatt, take it out. Harry. Jax, Cam, Wyatt.
Yeah, I'm in now.
Boston. Harry, V cut, pitch, double screen, Moss come around the double screen, 1-1. Read that, okay? Once we score, we take timeout. You understand what you're doing? Double screen at the top, double screen here, Moss is gonna come around, your man's trailing you, you curl. He goes underneath, you pop. All right? You know what we're doing? You know what you're doing? Good ball fakes. Shot goes up. Stop running away and get to the rack, okay? We have plenty of timeouts if you need it. Hey, stay here. Stay here. Relax. Look at me. You guys are working hard. Just keep working hard, okay? Long time to go here. We're all right. Harry, you're going to check out every time. Every time we check out. All right? Help with Savage, okay? When he drives like that against him, near side guy's going to dig down and help him out, okay? You know what we're doing now? All right, let's go get it. Let's go.
Coach in the huddle, cool, calm, collected. We know what we're doing. Okay, let's go.
Yeah, Luke Briggs has come up big. He had only 4 points at the half.
He's in foul trouble.
Right. Hey, shoot out. So he's got, what, 11 in the last 4 minutes, something like that?
Yes. We don't have live stats available tonight. So.
Yeah, we'll get it final. But, and there's a steal, the turnover, sort of an unforced turnover by the Mustangs. And the Seawolves obviously will not be in any hurry. Warburton out near midcourt, looking things over. Savage returns it to Warburton. They look underneath, they decide to go back outside. Six to shoot, Martinotti. Martinotti's gonna have to fire it. And didn't touch iron. Martinotti points to himself. It says, my fault. So that was good ownership by Thomas Martinotti.
He's done plenty of great stuff tonight. Oh, yeah. For sure.
But he wasn't pointing at somebody else. He just said, okay. Caldwell gives up his dribble. Bates comes out to Birmingham. They need some motion. Birmingham, bounce pass off a foot.
So Mustangs with 9 fouls. So if they have to foul Jim, they'll put him in the...
Yes.
We'll be shooting 2.
1 minute straight up to go in this two-possession game. They got to get it in. Birmingham spins. Hathaway for 3. Short. Caldwell elevated. Tried to tap. Couldn't get it, but Birmingham got the loose ball. Caldwell off glass. No good. Rebound Southern Maine. All right, coaching staff of Southern Maine giving them the message, which is don't have to rush it. Just like that, Warburton goes to the hoop, and he's going to have 2 shots. They were only halfway through the shot clock. Cayman Warburton at the line. He's from Worcester, Mass., went to Shrewsbury. Right down the middle. And very calmly, Warburton makes it an 8-point lead under 30 seconds. So Mustangs gonna get the ball in the air quickly. Off glass, Cam Pollock, timeout Mustangs. So, Rob, it's a two-possession game, 23 and a half seconds, 10 fouls on Central Maine, so it's 2 shots for Southern Maine. The Seawolves have 6 fouls, so it'll be a 1-1 in a non-shooting situation the other way, and the possession arrow right now pointing to the Mustangs.
In the huddle.
Try to foul Cayman, okay? Right away. You're panicking down here. Why are you shooting so fast? You got more time than you think. Relax, okay? We need a good start here, right? Come back and make a play. Okay? We score, we'll call timeout again. All right? Trap, if we don't get the inbound steal, we're gonna foul, right? We got try to get Kaden, but it doesn't matter. Or the big guy, either one. Okay? Right away. Get a steal.
Okay. Foul Randy if you can.
Wanna take this time to thank all the support folks down here at Central Maine Community College that make our job a lot easier, getting us stats, making sure we're set up. Coach Rodriguez sending us over water and nutrition from the Snack Shack. I want to thank our students that have been helping us. Joe Full Nelson on here tonight. Aspen Stevens, Andrew Sevenson.
I tell you, you and I worked together for a number of years on Thornton football, but when you got tied up with Central Maine and invited me, I'll tell you, it's always a positive experience. I've never had to come up here in any negativity of any sort. You know, coaches, staff, student athletes. So this is going to be two shots. Luke Briggs.
Well, certainly not the choice they wanted to make to put Luke at the line. He's been lights out, as he has been a great offensive player. I remember seeing one of his very first games as a freshman in high school was against Gardner early on in the season, and he came out shooting lights out. I said, who is that string bean of a kid? Yeah. He was, you know, as a 14, 15-year-old, just a little kid, and he could fire then, and he can fire now.
And obviously he's the, his Savage was tough throughout, but Luke Briggs, the last 10 minutes.
So 17.6 left, and
Vasquez third fouls to me, 1-1 for Jackson Birmingham. Okay, they're going to say we're shooting. It's going to be two shots. If he makes two, it'll be a two-possession game with 17.6 seconds.
Who's got shooter? Okay, your shooter?
And two out of two, that trip for Jackson Birmingham. Timeout, Central Maine, Rob, in the huddle.
If he pushes you, you got to push him back. You have to be strong. You can't be soft now, okay? When you're in tight with a guy, what are you going to do when you're tight with a guy? Grab a hold of him. Stay tight, grab a hold of him, right? As soon as he moves, you release. But you grab a hold of him, okay? Stay in front of him, make him throw the ball over the top of you. You understand that? Make him throw the ball over the top. We don't see him, we foul right away. On the ball. On the ball. Yep.
Don't wrap him up.
What? Whoever's passing in, it's on the ball. Okay, we got what we're doing? Relax. We just need a basket. Just about two or three.
So we have basket on the ball. He's the longest person on the ball.
Can't hit.
Basket should be on the ball. He's the tallest, longest person.
No, it's okay. We're all right. Here we go.
All right. Words from Coach Dave Gagne. We've seen stranger things happen. Be full court pressure, obviously. Martin Audi will inbound it. He gets it in with a little time to spare. And they call traveling. Central Maine ball with 14.8. So if you got another timeout, obviously they need a three-pointer, Rob. Let's see what Coach Gagne says.
Where's the five? One, two, where's the five? One, two, three, four, five. Okay. Where's the ball out of bounds?
Right this side.
Rick. Oh, sorry. No,
down six, coach.
Okay, we need a three. Here's what we're going to do. Boz, Wyatt, Cam, Harry. Who's that?
Jackson.
Jack, I want you to V-cut, come to the corner. If that happens, right? Cam, once you step this way, you set a screen. Boz, you hit the corner.
You're going to pitch here to that corner, and you're going to take that shot. You got it? Yes. Okay. You got it? You got it? Got it?
So, Rob, you have a final score? Of
not a final, but it looks like the Moose are up over the
Great Bay Herons.
Great Bay Herons, yeah.
Quite a few. Late in the game, I guess. All right, business here. Birmingham going to go to the hoop. Comes up short. And a three-point attempt never happened.
No, they couldn't get it.
Yeah. For Southern Maine, was obvious what they needed, a three for the Mustangs. Kenre Imadiro coming in for the first time, number 11.
For defense.
Teammate of Cam Pollock. And okay, Charlie Houghton was pushed by Cam Pollock. They call a deliberate foul. And I think a little overreaction by, it wasn't that rough in a sense, no. You know what I'm saying? I got screened a part of it. So it was a deliberate foul.
Yeah, it was deliberate, no question, but yeah, I was going to go back. I can't get a replay.
Yeah, I mean, the players are off balance. Charlie Houghton will take the foul shot. And rattles in and out. And Houghton makes one out of two. 5.6 seconds. It will be SMCC ball. And timeout, Dave Gagne. I think he's going to tell the team, like, don't foul. I'm guessing that's the message, Rob.
Yeah, we'll see. Well, we can go in and hear it.
You want to be punks? You want to be punks?
So we got an update. I just heard from our Nate Munsing that the UMA Moose won by 18. Over Great Bay Community College Herons. I'm telling you, that men's bracket is getting tighter and tighter all the way through. The Moose are on quite a run here to past four or five games. They've been playing really great. That's a big win for them.
Great Bay can usually score a lot of points.
Yes, they can. Yeah.
It's always interesting. The second semester comes, are any teams going to gain a player or two?
Right.
I don't know that, but. All right, great night of basketball. Let's end it positively here. And I think that was the message by Coach Gagne's. And that does it.
So that'll be the final.
So the Seawolves now 8-4 overall, 2-3. 3-2 in the conference. Mustangs fall to 5-8. They're 1-5 in the conference. As the first semester ends, and we're waiting for our final stats. Zach Mann doing a great job running them down to us. Since no live stats for this game. All right, thank you, Zach Mann. All right, let's go first to Southern Maine. For the game, they shot 39.7 from behind the arc, 29.2. Let's see, I'm trying to read this. Yeah, 39% from the floor, 29 from the behind the arc, 67% from the foul line. As they went 12 out of 18 at the foul line. Individually for the Seawolves, Kamen Warburton at 12 points. 17 for Luke Briggs. Again, he only had four at the half. Briggs was that key player in the second half, as Adam Savage was maybe earlier as far as points go. Briggs also had five rebounds to go along with 17 points. Fine all-around game by Thomas Martinotti. He had 15 points. Randy Vasquez, only 2 points, but he had 8 rebounds, always tough under the boards. Adam Savage, a lot of stats in a lot of different places, 18 points, 9 rebounds, and some of his plays were just super. Off the bench, they only got 5 points total. Cole Pulkkinen with 2, Charlie Houghton with 3. Houghton also had 4 rebounds. For Central Maine, for the game, they shot only 35% from the floor, 20% behind the arc, Rob. They were only 5 for 25 from long distance.
Yeah.
Very good job at the foul line, 11 out of 12 for 92%. Individually, Cam Pollock, double digits with 10. He had 4 rebounds. Jeremiah Simeon, 4 points, 8 rebounds. Boston Caldwell, 16 points. He had a couple of threes. Jackson Birmingham played a lot of minutes, 11 points, 6 rebounds, and 8 assists. And that's why Jackson Birmingham is very high in all the conference stats. Harry Bates, 5 rebounds, had 2 points. Off the bench with double digits, Wyatt Hathaway had 11 points, had 3 threes. Colin Wilson, 4 points, 2 points for Rocco Chang, and 2 points for Logan Myers. So as we go into the break, we'll be gone about a month from basketball. The Central Maine women defeated Southern Maine in a great game the whole way. Southern Maine controlled a lot of it, but due to the efforts of Destiny Mora Lopez with some help, it was Central Maine 60, Southern Maine 57, in a very competitive men's game. Wasn't until the very end that Southern Maine pulled around that 6 or 8 point lead. The final score, Southern Maine 69, Central Maine 62. As we wrap up and say happy holidays, see you next year, or what other cliches. Thank you to Joe Nelson on the camera, and always great working with you, Rob Munzing.
Thank you, Jim. Great job, and congratulations as we close this out, as our sleuth, Jim Toomey, discovered that it was going to be the 300th victory for Coach Andrew Morong, and nobody here knew it, and we got to celebrate that. And the scoop, I'm going to start calling you Scoop Toomey. Great job, Jim.
Yeah. I don't care what you call me, as long as you finish that check in front of you.
It's coming right up.
All right, thanks for everybody for their support, wherever you may be watching. So speaking for our executive producer, Rob Munzing, our cameraman, Joe Nelson, I'm Jim Toomey. Best wishes to all until the next time on Munzing Media Sports. So long, everybody.